Students, good afternoon to all. In today's class, I am going to explain about how to draw the block diagram for armature controlled DC servo motor. In last class, we discussed the transfer function of armature controlled DC servo motor. Now here in this class, we are going to be make that a block diagram. See, in DC servo motor, you have the three concepts. So what are the three concepts means? One is field controlled DC servo motor, armature controlled DC servo motor, and AC servo motor. So DC servo motor is two parts. One is a field control armature control. In that, field control DC servo motor is a open loop control system, and armature control DC servo motor is a closed loop control system. So you may get out of these three questions one question surely in your semester exam, right? So up to last class we discussed how to find that transfer function for the given DC servo motor. Now, so it is completely based on that mathematical equations which are involving in the circuit. So let's move on to the today topic. So you can see the diagram here. This is the diagram shows that armature control DC servo motor. So how we can say it is armature control and how we can say it is field control means, so every DC motor having the two parts. One is stator and rotor. So stator consists of field winding, rotor consists of armature winding. So here I am representing this two sections in separately. So this section is a field part and this section is armature part. Now in this for this circuit diagram, we have to be make that initialize that mathematical equations. From that you can make the block diagram. So for this we have the five blocks in block diagram. So we have to be find the five blocks. So first of all, I am going to be represent that mathematical equations in this diagram. So here the field, we are not considering the field circuit because it consists of constant voltage, so we can't able to change. Ante manaki eppudaina change edaina speed change kavalsundi mana field side etuvanti change cheyalem because it is constant. Edaina change vaste that is from the armature end. So that's why we are considering the armature circuit alone. Okay, the first equation from the armature circuit we can get VA is equals to, that is input voltage or input voltage to the armature is equals to IA into RA. So because IA is a armature current flow through the armature winding. IA into RA plus, when the current is, so we write LA into DIA by DT plus EB. So according to the Kirchhoff voltage law, the input source voltage is equals to sum of the voltage drop across the circuit. Okay, so this is the equation we can apply in that armature circuit. Next, second one is from the torque equation. The armature torque is directly proportional to that pi into IA flux into armature current. But here flux is constant because the flux is produced from the field wind. So flux is constant, then you will get torque is directly proportional to that IA. Now if you eliminate that proportional constant, you can get T is equals to KT into IA. Next, third equation you can get from the mechanical parts. Mechanical parts in sense, the torque is applied to the load, you will get T is equals to J into D square theta divided by DT square plus B into D theta by DT. Now here, theta is what? What is the representation of theta here? What do you call theta? data is what? Theta is an angular displacement, right? So now I am going to be this a. So this third equation is a represent of angular displacement. Now I am going to be convert this in terms of angular velocity. I can substitute j into d omega by dt plus j into for b into omega, because the relation between angular velocity and angular displacement, omega is equals to d theta by dt. Yeah. Now I'm just a substitute here. There is one more equation, that is back EMF. So back EMF is given by EB is equals to directly proportional to d theta by dt. So it means that how the armature is rotating, that much of EMF will be induced. Okay, so that's why the how much of displacement it covers by the armature, that much of EMF will be induced. So now I am going to be write this equation in the form of angular velocity. That is, EB is directly proportional to that omega. If you eliminate this constant, proportional constant, then you can substitute EB is equals to KB into omega. So these are the four equations we are going to be used that in block diagram representation. Okay, now from first equation, let me see that how we can apply. So we have to apply the Laplace transform to the equation one. Now I'm going to be apply the Laplace transform to the equation one. What you will get, let me see. So if you apply this transform, Laplace transform to this equation one, you will get VA of S equals to RA into IA of S plus LA into S IA of S, because it has the first order differentiation, plus EB of S. Now what we are going to, I am going to be bring this EB of S this side, VA of S minus EB of S is equals to, take IA of S common, IA of S into RA plus S into LA. Now here this is the output and it is the input. Okay, so this VA of S minus EB of S is an input and IA of S is the output. So according to our transfer function, output divided by input, right? IA of S So now this equation I'm going to be write in the form of transfer function, IA of S divided by VA of S minus EB of S equals to 1 divided by RA plus SLA. So this is the first block equation. So I am going to be represent in the form of block. So it should be like this. So I'm going to be make it as block diagram for this first equation. So let me see that how the block diagram will be. So the first block diagram having that input is VA plus VA minus IA. So this is the summing point here. VA as an input, VA of S, it is plus. And additionally here EB is adding in the form of negative sign, EB of S. Now this is giving to this block diagram having the transfer function 1 divided RA plus SLA, and its output is armature current. So this is the first block in the block diagram. Now you can clearly say that it consists of feedback element in the form of back EMF. Okay, now so this is the first block from the block diagram. Now we are going to be find the second block by using the second equation. So I just arrange this. What is the second equation? T is equals to KT into IA. Now I am going to be apply the Laplace transform to the equation 2. You will get T of S KT into IA of S. Now for this equation, I am going to be make the block. So this is the second block. That is whatever getting our output from the first block, that is giving to the input to the second block. So this is the second block. So here the input is what is output is coming from the first block. KT here. Now tell me that what is the input here and what is the output. So it is not KT, it is 1 by KT. Make it as KT. So it is KT only. What is the input here? And what is the output? You can input emotion, output emotion. See, first block diagram yaka output enti current. The same current is giving input to the second block. So here input is IA of S and output is T of S. This is the second block in the block diagram. Let me check whether it is correct or not. See here, this is the second block, that is IA of S, KT, T of S. Now I am going to be find the third block by using the third equation. So this is the equation, third equation, right? So I am going to be find this. See, this is the servo motor topic is very easy, but you have to be know that formulation. And if you know the equation, then only it will be easy. Otherwise, you can't able to understand the question. Now I'm going to be made as block for equation 3. So here the equation 3 is T is equals to J into d omega by dt plus d omega. Now I'm going to be apply that Laplace transform to this equation. You'll get T of s equals to J into S omega of S plus B into omega of S. Now from this equation, take omega of S is common. Omega S into J S plus B. Now T of S is equal to omega S into. So in that T of S and omega S, in these two, which one is input and which one is output? So omega of S is output. So omega output divided by input T of S is equal to 1 divided by JS plus B. So from this, I am going to be find that third block. So this is the block. And here we'll get 1 divided by JS plus B. And here T of S. And here omega of S. So this is the third block. Okay. Next, fourth block. What is the fourth equation? EB is equals to EB of S is equals to KB into omega S. So you will write for this, I can write. So for this equation 4, the block diagram is, so here omega of S is out input EB of S divided by omega of S is equals to KB. So now for this, the block diagram is, so this is the feedback block. So KB, here input is omega of S, output is EB of S. Now finally, by adding these four blocks, let me see that what you will get. Now I'm going to be add these four blocks. So the first block is summing point here. Here VA of S is an input. It is plus minus. And it is giving to the transfer function 1 divided by RA plus SLA. So from this, armature current is getting the output. Next, the second block is KD. Third block is 1 divided by JS plus B. So here, from so the first block for the first block output is IA. So here you will get IA here, and this is the same input to this KT, and here T of S. And here omega of S, and it is going to this same. Here KB is there. And it is EB. Now, what is the output here? From this block diagram, what is the output? Omega S, that is angular velocity. Now, I just want to make it as angular displacement. So what we have to do, we have to add one in 1 by S from here, block here. 1 by S, if you add 1 by S, then you will get the output is theta of S. That is angular displacement. Now, so I can tell you that how we can obtain this value. So you know that omega is equals to d theta by dt. Right? This is the relation between angular velocity and angular displacement. If you apply that Laplace transform, what you will get here? Yes, Sandeep. What you will get if you apply the Laplace transform? Yes, Nikola. Omega S equals to S into theta of S. Now, theta of S is an output. So, theta of S divided by omega S is equals to 1 by S. So, from this relation, we obtain this. So, this is the block diagram for armature controlled DC servo motor. Yeah. So, armature control DC servo motor is a feedback closed loop control system, and field controlled DC servo motor is a open loop control system. Now, next topic is AC servo motor. So, I am going to be explaining about AC servo motor. See, most of the servo motors used in low power servo mechanism are AC. So generally, okay, AC servo motor use, most probably they are choosing DC servo motor, especially for armature control DC servo motor. But if it is having the low range of applications, low power requirement means they can use AC servo motor, because AC servo motor, the AC supply is available when compared to the DC. So, okay, right. The AC servo motor is basically two-phase winding induction motor. So, two-phase, actually, AC and is single-phase gani, three-phase gani untundi. But here, it is a two-phase winding induction motor. The output power of servo motor varies from fraction of watts to few hundred watts. The operating frequency is 50 Hz to 400 Hz. So, here, you can give the input signal based on the frequency ranges. So, it can be capable to withstand 50 Hz to 400. So, the range is important. What is the operating frequency of AC servo motor? So, you may get question from this. 50 Hz to 400 Hz. Now, the terminologies we are using in AC servo motor are TF, that is torque developed by servo motor, theta, angular displacement of rotor, omega, angular velocity, TL, torque required by the load, moment of J, moment of inertia, B is frictional coefficient, K1, K2. So, voltage torque constant and speed torque constant. So, you can end the first to K1 and AD, input is the voltage is the then there are torque generated. Then, second K2, torque nichi manaku speed generated. Okay, na? So these are the two relations we are requiring. And EC is a rated input voltage to the armature. Now let me see that what are the equations we can see. So the torque developed by the motor is given by TM is equals to K1 EC minus K2 DT by DT. So here how we will get this relation means, I will explain you. So, the torque developed by the motor is equals to the EMF EC, the voltage is applied here, minus K2 d theta by dt. So it is opposing the torque equation. That's why we got negative sign here. Okay, now, the rotating part of motor and load can be modeled by equation 2. So this is the rotating part, and the rotating part is connected to the load, right? That's why I am repeating load torque. TL is equal to J into d square theta divided by dt square plus B into d theta by dt. So here are the equations important. So from these two equations, you can find the transfer function. Okay, now at equilibrium condition, the motor torque are equals. So under equilibrium condition, if there is no losses happening, then these two equations are equal, because two torques are equal. Tm is equal to TL. If it is happened, then you can equating these two equations, you will get equation 3. Now, what is the common term here, left hand side and right hand side? What is the common term? From this equation 3. Equation 3 lo common term em undi? That is theta. So we have to be bring this theta outside. So let me check how it will get. Now from this equation, I am going to be apply the Laplace transform, then you will get like this. So from this equation, just taken as theta of s is common. So theta of s is equals to k1 ec of s. So ec of s is an input and theta of s output. So t of s is equals to ec of s k1 divided by j square bs plus k2 s. Okay, now? So from this equation, we are going to be find in this way. So k1 divided by, so here take s as an common. If you take the s as common, s and both numerator and denominator is divided by bs plus k2, b plus k2, then you will get in this format. So finally, km divided by s into 1 plus tm. So this is the final transfer function for armature, that is AC servo motor. Okay, nah? So this is the servo motors topic. Okay, nah? Next, I'm going to be explain you how we can convert block diagram into signal program. So this is the topic next we are going to be discussing. So what is the main intention of this topic means? So most of them is not be finding a transfer function block diagram. Okay, block diagram you choose kani transfer function kanukodam chana difficulty anamata. Now how we can overcome this difficulty means, just we have to be convert block diagram into signal flow graph, then we can find a transfer function. So next topic is conversion from block diagram to signal flow graph. So this is the next topic. So let me see that what is the procedure. So procedure for converting. So ela convert cheyachu dini. So let me see here. Assume nodes at input. So mana block diagram chusin tarvata we have to make it as single flow graph, signal flow graph. So first assume nodes at input and output, comma, at every summing point, at every branch point, and in between the cascade box. So we have to be assume a node. Okay, now draw the node separately as a small circles and the number of circles in the order of 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. From the block diagram, find the gain between each node in the main. So I will show you that. So this is the block diagram. I am going to be converting this to the signal flow graph. So first point is you have to make it as nodes at input and output. So this is the input and output. Next, there is a, so here after that you have to be replace that all branch point and summing point by node. So we have, so I am going to be indicating here. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So except 5 plus 2. So totally we will get 7 nodes in that. So already we got 2 nodes from input and output. So I'm going to try the first input, first node, second node, third node, fourth one, and fifth one. So now you have to add these all things. So just indicate number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Next, we have the summing point here. So this is a 8 one. Next, see here, there is a, first of all, you have to be add. So from 2 to 3, there is again G1. So it is a G1 element. From 3 to 4, we have the, what we have? G2 here, G2 it is. From 3 to 4. From 4 to 5, so it is 1. 4 to 5, it is 1. 5 to 6, it is also 1. 6 to 7, it is also 1. Now, so next, from 3 to 4, there is a parallel block. So that is G2, G3. Next, 5 to 8, 8 to 2, and here 1. So this is the way we need to be apply the signal flow. So let me see that how we can get. So this is the diagram we can. So this is 3 and 2. So this is the block diagram. Yeah. So then you can clearly get that first they are going to be initiate that nodes at input and output. So tarvata input output tarvata remaining on 5 side total ga 5 plus 2 is 7 and 8. So we totally we have that 8 nodes in the diagram. So our 8 nodes mana ee vidhanga represent cheyali. Okay na? So this is the way of converting block diagram to signal flow graph. Okay na? So meeku deni paina konni problems chesi video send chestanu later. Okay na? So next we have the one topic is remaining from first unit, that is synchro. Okay na? So this topic if you ee topic tarvata meeku first unit complete ayipothundi tarvata meeku exam vetanu first unit paina. So you had to write that exam on first unit, then we will start the second unit. So okay students, this is about today class, that is a block diagram for armature control DC servo motor, that is transfer function of AC servo motor and conversion of block diagram to signal flow. Okay, right. Okay students, I'm going to end this class now. Thank you.